The turnout for the Grenland Beach cleanup was quite encouraging, with persons coming from as far as Anslery. It is hoped that this will pick up momentum and inspire cleanup activities in other areas as well. We met a number of groups on the beach, all shocked at the slaughter of a turtle that very morning, and all committing to do more to bring a halt to the senseless killing of turtles there. Among those who were at the beach that morning was Beatricia Gonzague of the I Believe in Voluntarism group from Anslery.
My name is Beatricia Gonzague and I'm the secretary of the I Believe in Voluntarism organization in Anslery.
Was this your first time here?
Yes. Yes, what an experience. First with the drive coming down here. Yes. But all in all, it was an awesome day. Our volunteers enjoyed what they did and we're happy.
Personally for you, how satisfying was it for you to be involved in this?
Very, very satisfying.
Is something you would encourage other groups to do as well?
Yes, and I'm hoping we can maybe take it down south of the island next. Yes. I would encourage all groups who have the passion for volunteering most of all to take part in activities like that.
Natasha Ditaville, I represent the Volunteer St. Lucia group.
Natasha, we've coming to the end of this activity here today. What is the experience like for you?
I must say it was a very, very productive day. My team, we got here say about roughly about 8:30 minutes to 9. We came here and hit it running. We got a lot of work done today. I'm very satisfied, I'm very happy, and I must commend my team for an excellent work done here today.
What is most pleasing for you today?
What was most pleasing is that all the groups came together and did such a fantastic job.
The job was huge because we saw the amount of garbage that was on this beach. It's a vast beach, it's like a mile long and it's very wide. When you saw the garbage, were you surprised at the amount of garbage that was there?
Well, actually when I came in, two things I was most surprised of. One, when we got here, the beach was extremely dirty. Two, it's a bit surprising but a bit sad. We got two turtles dead on the beach and we did not anticipate the amount of work that we had to do on our way here. When we came in here, I must say that we just took our sacks, put it down and just hit it running.
Now, you mentioned seeing two turtles there. How disturbing was that for you?
Very disturbing, because I heard about it before, but actually seeing it, it was quite disturbing.
What responsibility does the wider community have? Because I was speaking with one gentleman here who told me last night they could have bought turtle meat in a fish fry in Anslery. That means somebody's buying it from somebody. What wider responsibility do we have as a society?
As a society, I think we should not patronize persons selling turtle meat. And if we don't patronize, I don't think, actually, if there is not a buyer there, if there would not be anybody selling it. So I would ask persons not to patronize persons selling turtle meat.
Okay, my name is Joshua Verna, and I'm actually with the Customs and Excise Sports Club. I'm the president of the club currently. I'm president of the Monroe College Alumni Association, and I work with the Ministry of Education. I'm the IT manager over there. Coming here, the air is so nice and fresh, and it's lovely. But then walking down, we found two carcasses of two dead turtles. You know, it leaves you to wonder, but what are we really thinking? It's the case where we're just simply after the bread. You know, we want the turtle skin or the meat, I don't know. But at the end of the day, we need to remember that, you know, we need to leave something for our kids. I think it was a brilliant idea to clean the beach today. It's been stuff I've been thinking of, but not necessarily this beach. You know, but I'm hoping that from here, Ministry of Tourism could probably pay some attention to Grozile as well, because Pigeon Island needs a little love as well. I think it was a brilliant idea and I support it, and I will come back with my group and team to assist later on.
As we mentioned, officers and staff of the Ministry of Tourism were involved in the beach cleanup at Grenlands. We met with Donald Nviti, the Ministry's Product Development Specialist, rake in hand, as she returned from a cleaning exercise in the northern part of the beach.
Donald Nviti, Product Development Specialist, Heritage Tours, Ministry of Tourism, Heritage and Creative Industries.
We attempted to ask you what brings you here, but we have an idea. But put into context for us, what is happening here?
Well, certainly, from last year, the Ministry of Tourism, Heritage and Creative Industries, under its heritage tourism portfolio, and its quest to develop community tourism, try to work with the Debara Turtle Watch Group, since they had a lag for about a couple of years, 2 to 3 years. Must say, based on the intervention here today, we can record success in our intervention. to the point where we had not had a cleanup last year, but this year we could see the huge turnout, we could see the children bathing on our side. And it's really an ambiance of community people, volunteers, persons from various ministries coming together for the cause of protecting and conserving our turtle species who come to nest at the Grand Anse Beach. So indeed, this is our cause and we are here to support the turtle watchers. Of course, we have made contributions to make this day successful, as well as we have our own human resources with us trying to help with the beach cleanup.
Now, like you mentioned, a few activities happening here, so there's a lot of space for other things except the bathing, which is a bit too dangerous.
Right.
What are some of the potentials that we can start looking at? Because this morning we had a story about two guys slaughtering. They're obviously doing it for economic reasons, but what alternatives do we have for those guys?
But definitely, in terms of the beach and the resources it presents, it's an avenue for the community to really develop the capital. When I say the capital, I'm talking about the flora and fauna, not only the turtles who come to nest, but as well as bird watching and hiking the Lassosier range from Debara to Lassosier and other hikes that present itself. There are lots of species and animals that are available and present for persons to view. Of course, we have the potential of doing some lovely kayaking. Maybe you may want to take a shot of this for the public to see. So it presents a number of avenues for persons to engage in touristic activities from the community, as well as to probably develop some craft. You could see here my wristband is really a turtle, a wooden turtle. So all of these are avenues that crafters can engage in. We could of course continue to explore cassava making, local bread making, bread and butter, which is a really treasure for our visitors when they come to our island. Looking at what's available, the other resources of citrus and other mangoes and fruits and vegetables. We know that Debara is a farming community, so we don't only have the turtles coming to nest and the possibility of kayaking and bird watching and so forth, but we also have the farming who can play a large role in fortifying those visitors when they come to our community.
So there is a plan to increase focus on the Grand Anse Beach and to explore options for varying streams of economic activity. This could sustain livelihoods there and at the same time protect the marine reserve and its environs. Calabash community will maintain connection with the environmental, social and economic issues at Debara. That is our program for this evening. Join us again for another episode of Calabash Community. I am Bernard Fannis. Remember to check our Facebook page and our YouTube channel for this program and other programs from Calabash TV.